mighty Maxon Fuzz Elements Series Wind, and the Wind is a very large tip of the hat to the classic tone benders of the mid to late 60s that were mainly British, I think you will find. And it comes with a couple of added extras, well, quite a few actually. First of all, we've got a vintage and a hot setting, and the hot setting will increase the gain and also increase the bottom end. You've also got a buffered output or a standard vintage output to be able to choose from with this little mini toggle here, which is a pretty cool thing. Plenty of gain on tap, and you know, it's a tone bender, so it's not that subtle in terms of, you know, this is not a clean boost. It's going to give you those classic old raunchy fuzz tones from days gone by. First of all, this is a Mexican Fender / Roland Stratocaster with a GK1 pickup fitted in it. You're not going to hear that today, of course. And it's running through to the clean channel of a Laney VH100R. It sounds like this. Quite a good clean tone to start from, I believe. So first of all, let's start with the buffer on, actually the buffer off, and in vintage mode, and at the lowest gain setting. Bridge pickup. In hot mode. Still quite a lot of fuzz there, but you'll notice in hot mode there's a bit more bottom end. Let's wind it up to about 10 o'clock, back to vintage mode. Go to 3 o'clock, vintage mode again. Clean tune. It's a hell of a sound. All the way up in vintage mode. And in hot mode. Neck pickup. Afternoon in vintage mode with the buffer on. Let's have a listen to what it sounds like with some humbuckers, and I just happen to have here a very fine Gibson Les Paul faded standard with some Manalishi pickups in it, courtesy of my friend Larry Corsa. Manalishis are basically PAF clones from Peter Green's Burst guitar. Clean sound first, huh? Cleans up pretty well. Neck pickup. It's in lowest gain setting, you notice. Takes on a synth-y tone, which is kind of cool. Oops, the tone was all the way down then. Well, this is the tone bender that will not fail you because it's got hot or cold germanium transistors in it. In fact, I can't even tell you what sort of transistors are in the Maxon, but they'll be cool and they'll probably last forever. And the tone is pretty damn close to some of the originals that I've heard from that period. This is the Maxon from the Fuzz Elements series wind pedal. See you soon.